Hi, I'm Dottie Metcalf-Lindenburger, and I'm an astronaut here at Johnson Space Center. Why should you study math, science, engineering? Why not? Because it's so exciting. And let me tell you, I've been studying it for a long time, since I was your age, and even before. I became interested in space when I was about third grade, and that's because a lot of things were happening in the 80s. We had the first shuttle launches. We had the first American woman go into space. We had the first woman doing spacewalks. And we had Halley's Comet. We were getting information back from the Voyager and other exploratory spacecraft. And all this was coming in while I was in elementary and early middle school. And it made me super excited. So I started studying as much as I could. I'd study in my classes as well as on my weekends. Looking through magazines, going to the planetarium, asking my parents questions, going outside and looking up at the stars and trying to find Halley's Comet, which didn't work very well. But that's a different story. But I want you to be just as equally excited about science, engineering, and math, and technology. And here's why. Because we're going places. NASA's got big dreams too, and I hope you do too. We're thinking about exploring beyond low Earth orbit. And we're trying to build spacecraft that'll get us there. You guys are going to be the ones that go explore for us. And we're going to be using your minds and your dreams to propel us further and further into our solar system. When I was in seventh grade, my life science teacher had this experiment that we did where we brought in all of our food garbage and food waste. And we actually turned that into ethanol at the time, and we ran his lawnmower. And we went through a long process to make this ethanol. For a long time, our hallway stunk really, really bad because we were cooking up the food garbage. Then we were putting yeast with it. And then eventually we had to distill it. And it was a very smelly process. But during that process, I started thinking about how some the science principles that we were learning could perhaps change the way we do things here on Earth. I realized that I enjoy doing this, and again, science can take you places, and it can do good things for the Earth. One day, when I was teaching my high school class, one of my students asked me, "How do you go to the bathroom in space?" It's a great question. I didn't know what that toilet looked like. So I went to the NASA web. I found out just what the shuttle toilet looked like, learned how you can use it. And at the same time, they were posting for teachers to become astronauts. I thought, this is a perfect job. So I applied. I knew that it would be very unlikely I'd get the job. But again, I set my goals high and I worked hard. And so over a course of a year between medical examinations and between interview processes, I ended up getting my dream job. And since I've been here at NASA, I've been living my dream. And it's been quite exciting. I've met many new people, learned so much about our space shuttle, which is now retired, about the International Space Station. And I'm learning more now about our international partners and the vehicles that we're using to supply our International Space Station. So again, it comes back to you. What are you doing? What are you dreaming about? I hope you're excited about science, technology, engineering, and math.